Facebook Live. Okay, Tuesday. Welcome to Elevate Him as we go live every Tuesday, and it's always a joy for our ministry, Elevate, and all the team to join you guys. So just wanted to tell you, here's what we're in the middle of as we're doing Facebook Live. I've got my family, my son, my daughter. We're moving into a house. His girlfriend, where is she? There she is. And so here's the deal. We're right in the middle of the move. I'm going to walk you upstairs, and then I'm going to talk to you a little bit. But, you know, I thought about this today, and I think this is supposed to be turned like this. I'm probably crooked, but let me take this out of the camera, and I'll just hold this. I thought today, you know, you ever felt like it's never a perfect time? You've always got stuff going on. There's just craziness happening in your life, and you got kids coming and kids going and new packing and move and all the craziness that happens. But here's the deal. God is the God of peace in the midst of all that. When I camp out, look at all my deer heads stacked there. I hope we have hunters out there. But here's what I thought about. You know, we've lived in a house for 16 years, moved over to this house for 2.5 years, and now we moved out. And you go, why did you move out to the Weatherford area? Because God told me that we would only be there 3 years, and to be out by November. I started it earlier, and we moved out. And I don't know exactly why God called me out into this area of Weatherford and Aledo and Hudson Oaks, but I know this, it's to be a light wherever you go. So today, it's not the ideal time to be doing Facebook Live, right? Got all this stuff going on, but community matters so much to me in the midst of all of this. And I've got a small community, and then I'm very soon going to be moving from Gateway over to another church and joining that. And in the midst of all this pandemic and all that going on, I was talking to a pastor today, and here's the truth. I have learned during this time I need people way more in my life than what I realized. And we've got our good days, and we've got our bad days, and we all have a mix of those things, but we got to keep a good attitude as we go through that process. And so as we were unpacking or packing up, I was looking through, and you're looking at stuff that you don't need anymore, and you start trashing and throwing stuff away. And that's the same thing. Is sometimes we need a spiritual move in our life, that we start rummaging through the things of our heart. Proverbs 4:23, above all else, guard your heart, for out of the heart flows the wellspring of life. Well, you start packing stuff up, and it really comes to, do I really need this anymore? Or you give it away, or you sell it, or you throw it away, whatever it is. So I want you to look at the things in your life, and I know many of you out there are going, hey, this has just all come at the worst time, and I realize that, but we can hang on to Jesus as the peace that passes all understanding of our mind and our heart. And Isaiah says that he whose mind is stayed on the Lord will be fixed in perfect peace. What a promise. So this is just going to be a short Facebook Live, but I want to reach out to you and just ask you to pray for our family in this move. God's moving us. We're about 45 minutes away from where we used to live into a region and area. We don't know exactly why, but we know we're going to be a light. You hear all the movers in there? They've all been witnessed to today. So here's the deal. Pray for us that we will continue to step where God wants us to step. Talk about what God wants us to talk about, and love people the way that he wants us to love. And I've got a new message that's going to be coming out. Megan, Amy, myself are going to be sharing. And so I don't want to give it away. It's going to be an incredible series. We want you to join us. But for now, I'm asking for your prayers, that you would help us, and just pray that this would go peaceful for my wife, for my kids, and my family as we settle into this unknown region, so that we can be a light. God bless all of you. We love you. Sorry for the crookedness that I was doing. Does that bug you? I want to keep doing that. But anyway, love each and every one of you. If you want to contact us for prayer during this time, you can contact us at elevatehim.com, or you can send an email at info@elevatehim.com. And don't forget about the marriage conference that's coming up August 7th and the 8th. Don't wait. Come on, men, women, join us. We've already got a lot of registration happening, so we want you guys to be a part of that. And just here on the tail end, I think about this. We all go take our car to go get an oil change. We all take our car to get our tires rotated. But when it comes to our marriage, we put it off, don't we? And so why put it off? Even if you're in a good spot right now, get in a better spot in your marriage. Get around some other believers. You're going to hear some good messages. And I know Chad and Megan are away this week, and they've taken some time just to go get out in nature, spend time and hear the Lord. And they're going to come back with messages and words that will bless each and every one of you. So I don't care if you're in San Antonio, Borger, Florida, wherever you're coming to, if God calls you to come to this retreat, and I say retreat, this marriage conference, you're going to be blessed at Fully Connected. So make sure you go and register for that. And if not, we love you anyway. Blessings, and y'all have a great day. And remember, pray for us.